मुस्कुराते मुस्कुराते धीरे से आंखें बंद कर लें, जस्ट क्लोज योर आई विद जेंटल स्माइल, हैंड्स इन नमस्कार मुद्रा इन फ्रंट ऑफ द चेस्ट, बेस ऑफ द थंब टचिंग द हार्ट रीजन, जस्ट बिकम अवेयर ऑफ योर ब्रेथ. Now we are going to chant Om three times, and I want you to focus on the sound of Om. Where is the sound rising from? Where is it ascending? And where is it going? Om के लिए गहरी लंबी सांस लें. आंखें बंद रखें, कीप ऑन एक्सपीरियंसिंग एंड फोकसिंग ऑन द वाइब्रेशंस ऑफ ओम इन द बॉडी माइंड सेंसेस कॉम्प्लेक्स. विद अ जेंटल स्माइल स्लोली ओपन योर आई. Okay, you must have noticed that when you are chanting Om and focusing on the sound of Om and where it is coming from and where it is going, there was no other thought in your mind, and that no thought state gives us a state of peace, and this can no thought state, the beginning of the no thought state can be brought about by focusing the mind. The focus is the initial point of the triad of dharana, dhyan, samadhi. It is mentioned for the first time in PYS 2.29 as one of the eight limbs. Fair enough, no problem. The second time it is mentioned in 2.53 in reference to pranayama. Dharanastu cha Yogyata Manasa. This is where the concept of dharana becomes interesting. Up till now, Patanjali was going in a sequence, limb by limb. Yam, Niyam, Asana, Pranayama. Here, what he does, he mentions dharana before pranayama. And the interesting part is, he gives no explanation for this. Neither has he given any explanation, neither has any commentator critiqued this. Why has he mentioned dharana before pranayama? It is very interesting. Okay? And then the third time dharana is mentioned is in 3.1. it is interesting, I think, the importance given to dharana by Patanjali. Other than samadhi, dharana is possibly the only ang which is mentioned in two paths. Here, he gives the definition of dharana. Desh band chitasya dharana. Now, I have read book after book, commentator after commentator, articles on the net. They all say dharana is concentration of the mind on one point. It is the binding of the concentration of the consciousness to one point. I beg to disagree. Dharana is not the concentration or the binding of the consciousness to one point. Patanjali has very categorically used the word desha. Desha does not mean point. Desha means area. And the implications of this are, he is admitting that the dhyan, the focus, the dharana, the focus is not yet razor sharp. It is not very pointed. It is in a small area, but it is not a point. Had he meant point, he would have used a word like bindu or some other such word. Okay. And here, see, the root of the word dharana is dhri. That means to hold, to steady, to be fixed on. Okay. Dharana from the point of view of Patanjali may be translated as holding steady or single focus or collection of the focus of the mind. Over here, I would like to add my own interpretation. It is collection or focus of the mind joined with retention of breath. That is why possibly he has mentioned dharana in connection with pranayam. He has not mentioned pratyahar in connection with pranayam. In 2.54, he just defines what pratyahar is. In 2.55, he gives you the benefits. But going deeper into why dharana has been mentioned along with the pratyahar, this is the only conclusion I could come to. Sometimes it is important to study each word of a master craftsman like Patanjali. But it is also important to know what is implied by what he has not said. He may not say everything word by word, but he implies something. And that is the implication of, according to me, I stand to be corrected, why dharana has been mentioned in connection, in relation with pranayam. Then interestingly, I told you, dharana is mentioned for third time in 3.1. I've already told you about it. The word desh means area and not point. Dharana, from a practical point of view, is fixing the mind on a specific area. It is important also not that we fix it on anything. It is important that we fix it on a yogic object. And the yogic objects have been thought to be the center of the navel, lotus of the heart, the light in the head, the tip of the nose, tip of the tongue. And it should be auspicious, such as a deity also. When we focus the mind intensely into one area, the rest of the mind tends to quiet down. when the mind quietens down, there is less room for thoughts and other distractions to come in. And that, in a sense, is preparing the mind for dhyana. Dharana is the initial step, first step of concentrative meditation. Vyas has commented, this triad of dharana, dhyana and samadhi is the direct means to sampragnata samadhi. Shankaracharya says, yoga can be affected even without going through the five limbs of yoga. By the mere accomplishment of the triad of dharana, dhyana and samadhi. But without that triad, yoga is not possible for anyone. Because yoga is essentially associated with the operation of dharana and the other two. Even in our epic Mahabharata, the importance of dharana is shown. At a time, Dronacharya calls the princes and he wants to test their focus for in an archery skill. There's a statue of the vulture put high up in the air. Call Duryodhan first. Ask him to shoot at the head of the bird. Duryodhan is about to take aim. Or takes aim, and Dronacharya asks him, what do you see? Say, I see the cloud, I see the tree, I see the leaves, I see the bird. He says, shoot. He shoots and he misses. The next prince comes, and the next, they all say the same thing. Till Arjun comes. Dronacharya asks Arjun, what do you see? Arjun says, I see only the eye of the bird. He says, shoot. He shoots and he doesn't miss the target. All the others had missed the target. This is an example of focus. Yeah. Dharana is basically training yourself to meditate. Dhyana is the actual state of meditation. Now, dharana practices are being passed off as meditation. They ask you to do a visualization, focus on something, focus on your breath. And just this simple focusing makes people feel good and they feel they have meditated and, you know, they feel great about it, not knowing that they have not meditated. Actually, they've only done dharana. Dharana is, see, whenever I give a talk on yoga on any of the angs, I like to present something new, a new perspective, and also as to how a thing, that ang is applicable in our daily life. Okay. I've already given you a new perspective on why dharana has been mentioned before pratyahara. Now, other than breathing, I think dharana is something which all of us in our daily life are applying to some extent or the other. But we are not aware of it. When we're reading a book, when we're studying, when we're watching TV, or anything that holds our interest, holds our focus interest, is dharana. When it becomes yogic, is when we become aware of it, that I am doing this. If it's happening without awareness, it is just simple paying attention. It becomes yogic when you become aware of that attention. And why? Why should we have dharana in our life, in our daily life? See, whatever we pay attention to, we connect to that. And we connect to that not only at a physical level, when we keep paying repeated focused attention to something, we connect to that intuitively. Dharana is like any other muscle. The more we practice it, the more we can improve it. We can make it sharper. We can make it stronger. Up till now, multitasking was considered a very desirable skill. Well, I can do 5 things at one time. I can watch TV, talk to my boss, you know, work on an essay or something like that. Until people started cracking up. Now people are coming back to the old principles of do one thing at a time. Be focused on what you do. And that very simply is dharana. Being 100% on what you do. Do it completely na. Man laga ke kijiye. That is dharana in everyday life. You know. It is a practice of controlling your mind and taking your mind where you want it to go instead of letting your mind take you where it wants you to go. Okay. When you're fully engrossed in your current task, there is no room for indecision or debate. You can practice it in your everyday life. You can set timer for tasks. You can decide that I'm going to be focused on this, just this one task for a certain amount of time. Whatever that work may be, even if it's just washing dishes or having a cup of tea, just be totally involved in that. It is when we are not involved, not focused in that one task, other thoughts come to the mind. Okay. Dharana, you can bring dharana to your yoga practice also. When you focus only on the breath, you call prana dharana. You can focus on an intention. You can focus on a mantra. Actually, even mantra jap and prayer can be looked upon as dharana practices. That is the reason I made you chant Om right in the beginning, so that your mind gets focused on this talk. Okay? And I will conclude by saying that if the feet of dharana are grounded in pranayam pratyaha, then the heart of dharana is dhyan, and its upward ascension fortified in the clouds of dharma made samadhi. Thank you.